A&E did a biography about Booker T. Of course, it's coming out soon on A&E television. But if the people listening right now in Houston want to get a sneak peek of the A&E biography about the WWE legend that is Booker T, here in H-Town, they will be having a special drive-in event on Tuesday, April the 6th at 7 o'clock at the Moonstruck Drive-In here in Houston, Texas. And you can get an early screening and free giveaways of the biography book. I'm excited. I want to see it in person.
I was just reading that today that it's going to be in select theaters and in a few cities. And that's right. That right there, I'm like, man, that's pretty cool, man. That's pretty
awesome. I think Houston, Atlanta, Indianapolis, Memphis, Detroit, and Philadelphia.
Yeah. So I'm looking forward to letting the world see what Booker T was like as a youngster, where he came from, you know, the foundation I was built on, it was real, man. It was real. Being on the streets, seeing it live up close and personal, the bright lights, man. We talk about the bright lights of, these are big arenas, you know, when it's filled with 50,000 people and the people are going crazy, you know, but the bright lights for me, man, was, you know, on the streets of the waterfront, you know, back in the day, man, and watching everything go on. It was like a literally like a fiesta, like a Mardi Gras, man, every weekend from a perspective, you know. I understand, you know what I mean? I understand what life is really, truly all about, being able to see it up close and personal the way I did. And that's what the documentary talks about. It definitely doesn't glamorize what I went through or anything like that, but it definitely shows as far as, man, you could, you know, see the bottom of the bottom and you could rise above it. You can make it up out of there. That's what my story, I think, entails more than anything. And that's the story that I was afraid of getting clouded a little bit just because of the way I did come up. One could think one is glamorizing that, but which, you know, no, that's not it at all. It's just like for me, you know, saying the N-word on television. I don't glamorize that. That's something I wish I could take back. You know, seeing that life up close and personal the way I did, do I wish I could take that back? not in a million years. You know, I swear, man. Because, man,
well, everything you're not makes you everything you are, right? I mean, everything that happened got you to the point you are today.
Yeah, man. Seriously, I think everything I saw and did back then definitely. And I was definitely mischievous. I definitely was trying to get my piece of the action. You know, my champagne wishes and caviar. I definitely was doing things that a young kid, you know, 12, 13, 11, 12, 13 year old kid shouldn't have been, you know, doing, you know, but it was like, it was there. And then people are like, well, no, what is he talking about? Well, you know, when you, the place where, you know, they're going to talk about it on the doc, just to give you a sneak peek, place called the Waterfront. It's where all the pimps used to hang out, all of the pushers, you know, drug dealers, and, you know, all of the prostitutes, you know, used to be in that area. And I normally would be riding with one of the pimps, you know, in a big Cadillac, you know, listening to some, you know, Willie Hutch, and that was kind of like my education in life, watching these men deal with these women. And I was like, wow, it was almost like a life lesson that, man, if this is a trade that you can go into if you want to go into it, you know. And I was literally kind of like getting coached along the way. But for me, I talk to young people and I tell them about that fork in the road. When you come to that fork in the road, you can either go one way or the other. And for me, after seeing and doing so much of the youth, I always want to go the right way. I never want to fall into those pitfalls. I never seen any of those guys retire. Never seen those guys have, you know, great family relationships or anything like that. You know, I never seen any of those guys, you know, hanging out with their kid, you know, playing ball or anything like that. It was never anything like that. So it's a choice in life that you have, and I believe in those choices. That's why I, you know, with my students at Reality of Wrestling, or my kids, you know, that I have. It's hard for me to accept excuses, you know, because that's all they are, excuses. You know what I mean? Don't tell me that you can't do that. That's just an excuse. But when you can go over there and, you know, and do that without no problem. So life is all about choices and making the right choices. And hopefully my story will help some young, you know, kid that's, you know, somewhat in, you know, perhaps in those same shoes, looking at it from that same view, from that same perspective, and say, man, you know, this may seem cool, but I don't think I want this. You know, I think I want better. I think that's what my story is really all about. Guys, you're in the Hall of Fame.